So we're gonna play the third crash game and see if we can wrap this up. I guess if you get everything, you do blow it up. Because I never actually blew up the space station.
Free at last.
Oh no, he freed some evil spirit. Hey, it's the polar bear from the last game.
Uka Uka is free? No, it cannot be. Evil, great evil has come.
None have dared fail the great Uka Uka even once. But you, Cortex, you have failed me twice.
Great Uka Uka, it was that infernal bandicoot.
From deep inside my temple prison, I sent you simple instructions to follow. But you lost the gems, you lost the crystals, and I have lost my patience. There is now no other power source left on this planet.
I know we've had a few unfortunate setbacks.
And failed. But since your bumbling has managed to set me free, I am feeling generous. There is still a way to amass the power needed to enslave this miserable planet. And this time, the great Uka Uka will make sure that you do it right.
After many eons, my evil twin brother, Uka Uka, has been freed from his underground prison. Long ago, I locked him there to protect the world from his malice. Now, free once again, he must be stopped. Children. Uka Uka and Cortex plan to use this time-twisting machine to gather crystals that lay scattered across time. I have brought you here to recover the crystals before they do. To open the time portal, simply stand on a button and then jump into the portal. Good luck.
Right. DLC, sure.
Crash, crash, crash. Why must you always muck in my mud? Oh, look, I have a mask helping me too. We will find out which one is more powerful soon enough.
Goat's got a little N on his back. made a noise now. Question mark blocks. I mean, I guess there's one of those in every game? I've gotten over 100 apples at this point. Nice. Forgot the bonus game apples count separately. I ran into it. We've got, like, evil bandicoot there, I guess. Okay. Okay. I'm definitely thinking a little bit. That's exactly what this series needed after all of its some of its questionable platforming decisions. You needed water levels. I mean, there's no platforms down here, at least. Okay. Boxes. I wonder where that ramp goes. That box. If that's the only barrel I'm missing, I'm gonna be upset. There are another five. Aww. Wasn't Tiny in the last game as like the big dumb tiger? wasn't quite long enough of a jump. Okay. I mean, I guess I could have spun these barrels open. Barrels? Boxes? Game. Thank you. I think that's two boxes that we've seen that we haven't gotten. One second. Welcome to Wave Race. It is Tiny Tiger. Cortex is actually overseeing that, supervising. If this keeps up, I might have to actually bail for a minute. He was a jumper last time, too. Okay. So because our boss is too easy, we're going to intersperse it with dodge the boulders. Because this game was probably made when The Lion King was popular. Say to do.
By defeating Tiny, you have unlocked the gate to the next time travel area. Go back to the center of this time twister and save your progress if you wish. From there, you will see that the gate to the second time travel area is now open.
Okay. What did it say about Super Body Slam? Oh, so I guess I did not have the body slam until this point in time. I don't recognize this bat character at all.
Why must you continue to be a thorn in our side?
Who? What? Where was I? Oh, Tiny was a good fellow. He hated everyone and everything. But a good heart, nonetheless. Please be more reasonable with my minions next time.
How's he doing? Aww. I like how if I like graze a barrel of nitro, like it's all over. But if an enemy like literally swings an appendage or a sword or something through it, that enemy is like absolutely fine. There is no verisimilitude. How much do I care about that box? I have to try once, I guess. You ever feel like you just weren't wearing your glasses for a second? Seen more boxes than we know we've seen some nitro. Second stage, I've been one short. Yellow gem. Can't move while spinning on these. I mean, it makes sense. It looks like it could be, but it probably isn't. Are you paying attention to the whole screen trap? Or trick, at least. That was odd. I need TNT to break this whole mess open. Got it. Yep, it was like basically those three. Yeah, I don't know where they're going with this. They're just like kind of throwing random backgrounds that they haven't used yet at me. I haven't saved since before the boss. Only 9% right now, though. That's good. This percentage is, like, growing slower. Maybe it's bad, though, because, like, do I really want to do more than 30 stages? Good. It closed on me. That is oil. Okay. What's up, Conster? Actually starting to get tricky with some of these. That's much better than spamming one-ups at you, giving you the extra hit and saying, like, by the way, there's a thing coming. Any blowholes up ahead? How do these work? Give this guy a flamethrower. I did Mega Man 8 earlier tonight in Strizer's Marathon. It was fun. Kalen did commentary. And we got the Legacy Collection 2 time. It was good. It was good. It might be bad. Siberian Bull said he wanted the money to go towards Donatello.
G'day, mate. Dingle Dial's the name. And Uka Uka and Cortex gave me orders to bring the crystals to them during the Ice Ages. So give me the goods and shove off, or I'll roast you.
So, like... was this like a late 90s fad of we need to have dialogue from bosses that are going to be on screen for 2 seconds? Like 2 or 3. That jump had questionable distance on it. That pattern made sense. See, they're fine. Why don't they just get up and keep going? Some classy stage design going on here. The blind pit. Yo, we got it. Is that a count it? Count it. Tiger can make this jump, it just can't make any of the other jumps on the stage. Good Tiger. Aww. I get the impression there's like one of these stages I completely missed. And it might be the first one. It's either the first one or the second one. You got that one. You got that one. We need to do this one. So is this what the nitro fueled game is? Is this a required vehicle stage? Like, let's try something else that every other series has done and put him on a bike. Haven't you played like those Mega Man games? They're on PlayStation now and they've got bikes everywhere. You can't play an X game without him being on a bike anymore, and like everybody loves that. So what? All right, I guess I have to go back in for the crystal. Because why not? There is a seventh down there. I didn't really notice that before. That puts us in a completely different mindset right now. Apparently cutting the corners to that degree is a bad idea. Yeah, I figured that out. Hey, it's the picture of the guy from the other game. To like just tap the brake to kill the boost. I really thought he just got like crushed by that car, because like the animation of the warp appeared at like the same time. We got it. Dingo dial.
Right. Now you've gone and done it. Them crystals are mine.
Break out the button. Oh no, look how evil he is, threatening a penguin that would kill me if given the chance. Oh no. I'm gonna run left this time. I didn't even see him winding up his shot. Yeah, just keep it up there. I'm going to bed. Have a good night. There was a good opening. Get out of there.
No worries. You'll soon be up against much worse.
Oh, baby. We got the ultimate platforming ability.
Haven't we gotten far for a pair of fuzzy marsupials? I am Dr. Nefarious Tropy, master of time and the creator of the very time twister machine you see before you. Uka Uka yes. And Dr. Cortex have sent me to end this little charade, so you won't be leaving my area with the crystals. I swear it.
One second. All right, never mind. That's through. Okay. The last game didn't really have a cohesive theme to its stages either. It just kind of was. On some level, right, how much do I really want to complain about a video game that has random platforming stages? Right then. I'm kind of tempted to see if the little guy can survive it. What if he doesn't? I'm not, let's just on like continuous run for it. I'm actually, I have full control. Okay. Oh, good. We get more chases after this. Okay. What even just happened? Not enough this time. I remember that from last time. Let's get in here. Backtrack to find the special gem. It is definitely true that as long as I have a ranged attack, yes, I can take out the nitro barrels now. Like, either there's a place to hide, or I can just outright spin attack the... the sharks. So my suspicion is that just being in the flow would have killed me. This is a long way to backtrack. I'm pretty sure I still need a, I need something to reveal. If I could have hit that from before, from earlier. Yeah, now we're in Donkey Kong Country. Sure.
So, you pesky little rats aren't going to back off, eh? Just you continue to gather crystals and see what I do.
Now I see it. There's definitely like a little bit of where is that even coming from? They're gonna have a Super 16. Game list announced tomorrow before the June 20th event. I mean, I guess it's good to make sure we know that those are things before we get like far enough from the stage that we get frustrated when we start getting owned by them out of nowhere. To be able to. Otherwise, that doesn't make sense. Oh, come on. That's what I mean about ledge clipping. Why would you even make your game have that platform that like wasn't lined up? And like I was only just hitting left from here. Well, no, I guess I have to do that to get these boxes. Sometimes you forget you have the ultimate ability. I can't double jump off a TNT bounce. Walls now. Well, most enemies walk into explosives and they just get owned. He always seems so happy to collect gems and crystals. So, like, what are the police cars actually doing here? That's the real question. As far as I can tell, they're just obstacles. I'm not certain I actually lost any time on that mess. Just sending us completely out of bounds now. Let's give this one more go. Thank you. I don't know if this stage is going to be like the one stage where using the stick is actually advantageous over using the pad. But so far it actually feels like it might be. I guess the good part of doing these stages is I'm gonna get a ton of the apples. I was like steering right and then I hit the zipper and it was like, no, you want to go left. I'm like, no, I want to go right. No, not this one.
Crash, Coco.
Now we're done. Oh god. Alright. I'm actually gonna call this here for now. What is this, like half the game? So there's that. I think I have more lives here now because I did that course. I'm just glad you can like get the gem without winning the race. Oh, what? I mean, we're going to finish at this point, but... This bike has no maneuvering. We got the boosts. Racing game 101 strats here. Oh, that's a break. No. Let's keep this going. Okay, why was I just not able to turn there at all? I feel like I almost need to like ask somebody what is the trick to this level. Bro, Infernape, have you ever, like, actually beaten this game? Because I'm trying to figure out what the trick to making this bike actually, like, do what I want it to do. Because it feels like its handling is awful. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. You've made the right choice. I could like do this, right? I can do all the classic, just take the inside curves, but it's hard to stay on the track, and then you've got to hit this boost, and this boost wants you to do a very specific thing. It feels like I can't turn once I hit the boost. I'm stuck like doing what the game wants me to do. which is just awful. Like missing that one there. Like Crash is like automatically trying to veer to the left. To the right. I'm holding left. Oh, the weekly's not being restreamed. That makes some sense. Like, these big sweeping curves are easy enough to get around. And I understand where, like, if every bike level was the same, you'd end up with a boring level, which is almost worse than a challenging level. But at the same time, like, this is challenging because it's impossible to steer, not because it's, like, an impossible course. Like, it's actively trying to work against me. And there's nothing I hate more than, like, unresponsive controls. It's the reason I played Resident Evil Zero for, like, 30 minutes. And then I was just done. Because I did not want to deal with it anymore. Yeah. Let me try the D-pad again and see if that does anything any better for me. I feel like it wasn't that useful last time, though. Like I Ugh.
do that. Oh, wait, again there's no game audio? You're kidding me. Now it should be back because I hit the thing. This is the same thing as earlier. This is going to be like the downfall of trying to use the retro tink. If I have to mess with game audio every time I go to stream. I feel like without making contact with the lead card, there's probably a set time I need to get in order to win. PlayStation 1 did not have anything resembling tactile feedback or like any sort of analog levels of pushing R2. So this, I would hope, is still in the, I just push the R button down and I go. And it's not, well, because I'm holding it all the way down now and it wasn't earlier that I'm like going faster. That would be dumb. Went under it. That's weird. I still think that was the move. And because this car has no steering, this bike has no steering, I guess is the more accurate way of putting it. Oh yeah, I mean, that's the good thing about this. We're raking in the lives. I'm starting to think that's what it is. I just need to like actually squeeze R2 to get all the acceleration out of it, as opposed to, you know, a normal game where you just hold the button. Because I know I'm like breaking around a lot of these turns, but I don't really see where I would want to like not be flooring it, except for like the points where I'm breaking. like actually understanding what the game wants me to do there to, as part of the get all the way around the curve process. That's the other thing I would really just love to know. And that's what I'm doing here, is I'm just letting go of the gas. Rather than trying to deal with it.
This was dumb.
This whole level was dumb. Yeah, like zero control after a boost. So now I'm guessing like the sound disappeared. I'm gonna go back to this, and it's probably back, which is dumb. So I guess like if I switch resolution, I have to like completely stop OBS or do something. Okay, yeah, that's just really dumb.
Well, you've crashed a few parties before, but I never expected you to make it this far. If you don't turn back,
I will put 1,000 years of suffering on you and the entire universe.
Oh, race was still. Oh, wow, what? The race is at 10, right? Or is it? Or are they doing it at 9? Are you gonna actually join this one then, Pro Infernape? Yeah, I mean, that's a thing, too. Blue Wizard Robes in the overworld, like, you just can't be upset about them. You know, just kind of accept that that's a thing that happens and move on. And just avoid them as much as possible. The tracker does help a lot with, like, knowing what things are possible. It's like its primary focus as far as I can tell. Yeah, the tracker basically covers that. Tracker has like little dots on it, which is a little harder to understand at first, but it definitely, like, I mean, the only way to learn is to just start doing it, right? Yeah, the consternation what now is first quest check. It's first quest only. So I should go up by 3 in just a second. The randomizers really are just jump in. The only thing is if you're jumping in on a race where there's no voice chat, then you're kind of, as your first race, stuck trying to figure out exactly where to go sometimes. But yeah, you'll get the hang of it fast enough. That's also true. Doctor, entropy.
Ah, you little vermin are way too stupid to understand what you're getting yourselves into. This time, you've done it. Now you're on my time, you little skunk. Give me the crystal.
Okay. Okay, now hang on a second. Lame that he appears on the other side and there's like you're basically done because you thought maybe to try the other thing. Depth perception, how does it work? I'm really not a fan of my Bandicoot like being shattered by the forces of space-time. The double jump also like works very oddly. Shapes. Okay, I'm trying to figure out exactly what's happening here with some of these. We got him anyway. I've done so many slide jumps in this game that go off ledges, and then that's the one where it doesn't let me do it. Oh my god. This game, this whole collection has such questionable physics. And I've got to stop doing these double jumps. That one I'm starting to think the trick is to actually just stay low anyway, and it probably just will never hit you. Yeah, the yellow dots. That's where you want to bomb. It's not always clear. I'm not going to claim it is. But, it's clear enough that you definitely at least have an idea of what you're supposed to do on the screen. Bomb walls for caves can only ever be up. We made it.
But your soul will be too.
Death tornado spin. Cool.
Twister machine is very delicate. Without Dr. Entropy's constant care and control, who knows what it will do?
If only you didn't do the thing that's gonna make us like stop in time. Can they both do that? Not that I think I've seen Coco in an actual stage. Sphinxinator. Good to see everybody again. All right, what's in the bad path here? See if we learned about our new mechanic. Yeah, I kind of saw that those were there. Went for it anyway. Oh my god. I'm holding up and I'm sliding, and he slides right directly towards the nitro. That just happened to be the spot. I guess I go this way. Boom. I should be able to slip, just walk right through them while they're up at this point. Yeah, that was the next thing I was kind of curious about. How far back am I? Whoa. All right, we didn't get squished. I probably should have left them there to get 5 apples every time I respawn here. Hooray for the tornado spin, right? Need to watch this long transportation cutscene again. I feel like I'm getting caught in, like... did it. I hit jump a second time and it didn't give me the double jump. I reiterate that this game is just awful. Screen scrolling. There's not really a great one. Hang on. Can I just do this forever?
The one thing you remember is you want to hit the D-pad in perpendicular to the direction you're actually trying to go. So when you see, you basically get like three or five, it's, I think it is both three or five pixels away from the left or right of the screen, and tap, you have one frame tap of up and down. So even though Link turns from left to right or right to left, you're actually tapping on the vertical. Either vertical works. Same way with block clips. You walk up so that kind of the top of Link's hat's kind of starting to go into the bottom of the block, and you tap. You don't tap down. You tap left or right, and Link looks down. And then you can go up. That's your clipping sort of tutorial. Let's see what happens here. Someone's on YouTube watching this to see somebody blind play Crash 3 and is like, why the hell are we talking about Zelda 1 block clips? And I'm not sorry. Okay. We have a health meter all of a sudden. Let's start with that. About to say, isn't that what happened to that last one? Why am I still airborne?
I had an injection last year before I was
out. Yeah, everybody wants Wiz Robes to roll down 2 hit points. Oh, this guy again. Definitely care more at this point about just being the video game. Was the second half of the stage just on the other side of those buoys? Questionable stage design. Basically go down the path of you just can't do this because we said that, because we said so. That's right. I just
destroyed that shark with my damage boost. Whoa. I feel like the pirate ship path is probably the correct choice, but oh well. I guess we're gonna get a pirate ship either way. Okay. Where's that other, where's that rowboat going? I was kind of hoping that that wouldn't happen. It's like right there. Coco's just mad at us. She's like not actually hurt. She's just disappointed. The anchor was the actual death. There's gotta be a screen scrolling tutorial available though, I just don't know where it is. If not, let me get through this world at this point. Even tapping it while it was closed was damaging. That's disappointing. Alright, so this one, if I spin it, like, nothing good happens. Alright. Alright, we'll just go over. That time it. This game and like any level of hit detection. Oh, these don't even trigger based on you being close to it, they just trigger. Probably all explode from just the one of them. That was not the the slide button at that point. How does it work? You know, I guess I do have a sliding arm. I can just do that. Nice. That's step one. Back to here. That was kind of lucky. Let's mark down that this stage happened. Tomb Waiter. I got it. I would have moments where I get it like 10 times.
Yeah, my PB is 3.
Yeah, okay. He still just drowns. There you go. Yeah, it's not that hard to do.
Yeah, that's the thing about it. Like, once you know how it's done, like, the part where you actually do the clip is the hardest part. Like, conceptually, it's really simple. Death Path. What's going on here? These platforms. I'm trying to figure out where my escape route is here. Oh good. Okay, so there's nothing there. Blue? That's an exit. He seems very excited about that. See, the hardest thing is, like, realize the screen scrolls aren't incredibly, like, the most useful, urgent thing you need. The biggest thing it does is it gives you easy access to West Death Mountain and, like, the grave area from above level 1. That's really the only time you should be focused on using it in the overworld as a new player. Underworld and, like, dungeons, block clipping inside of diamond staircases is the biggest thing. But yeah, don't worry about HUD clips. I don't even know how to do a HUD clip. And like apparently it's really easy to soft lock with the HUD clip. Too long to make a jump. I need to start this again. That would be a story. Well, I mean, it's not a hard lock, so like you can. It's not even really a soft lock, cause like a true soft lock, you can't get F. Actually, that's the other big thing. You know how to up A, right? That's a dumb question, but it's an important one. You pause the game and you push up and A on controller 2. If you're using a, you know, four face button controller, like the SNES controller or a PlayStation controller or something like that, highly recommend making the other buttons, like if it was a SNES controller, X and Y. This is a PlayStation controller, so I have triangle and circle set to be up and A on controller 2, respectively. Yeah, I mean, that's why I mentioned it. Because, like, the moment you walk into a shutter door room with Gomas or Dodongos and you don't have arrows or bombs is the moment you're going to be like, because there's actually no torment races tonight. Or at least it feels like they're all later. Man, just jump into the fire. No better way to do it.
and Darby and his 2,000 viewers. Jealous. I love it. That's fine. Dude, don't burn yourself out on it either. The fact that you are doing it so much is actually awesome. I can see where there's a little bit of... Relax. You're crushing everything and we love it. Believe me. I'm almost positive they love you. Mario Land 2 is the most popular game on Twitch. I think I see the steel blocks that must have appeared because of this steel block. I could like swim underneath these blocks. Crash dies and like can't swim if he enters water, but there are water levels in this game. Yeah, I mean, you don't have to kill yourself with these races. If you're having fun though, I mean, yeah, do it. Yeah, I forget when I really picked that up. I think it was, I watched the time trial video at the beginning of Crash 2. And I saw that, like, Bobby the Blacktastic was, close. And then I eventually watched the top run and saw that slide spin, slide spin, slide spin, and said, wait a minute. Did I watch that run, or was it the, yeah, I must have watched that time. And I'm kind of like noticing now the, okay, that's a thing. Oh good, a completely blind turn. Certainly there's nothing bad that can happen right here. Survey says there's one box somewhere in the stage. I've had a lot of stages where I finished with one box missed. So we're going to try and do this, and then I guess we'll sort of, I don't know, we might have more time. This stage, this world didn't have like a really bad vehicle level in it. It just had a mediocre vehicle level. Oh.
So, you want to go a few rounds? When this is over, we'll see who is obsolete.
Oh, sweet. What are my moves again? Suddenly we're playing Star Fox. Ow.
Feels like there's more buttons that I should be able to push here. I think you're due for this one. I haven't gotten many of the onks. Okay. Oh no. Oh wait, what? Why is my tiger? Happened that I lost like a billion health. I'm vaguely aware that there's like an off-screen missile that I didn't touch at all. This game is aware that I played Star Fox, right? Alright, I don't even have to mash, I can just hold the button. Mech wrecked again. Firefruit, hold L2, raise the gun. Okay. That's something that makes sense, I guess.
It's funny how history repeats itself. Yet again, Engine has failed to defeat you.
What? For this we must destroy you!
Oh, my aching head. I'm not feeling myself these days. So, the end is in sight. Gather another 5 crystals, and again you will have foiled my plan. Or will you?
Oh. So the problem with what he just said... is that, here's stage 31. Why would there be a 31 unless this went up to 30? I'm on to you, game. Yeah. Alright, so if you're here for Crash, you probably see that it does say this until Zelda 1 Weekly. Zelda 1 Weekly is at 10, so I'm going to start setting up for that as well. Probably tomorrow night I'll try to wrap this up, because it feels close-ish. And then I can take this out of the PlayStation 4 forever until somebody says let's race Crash 2, because it'll be fun, because I'm actually down to do that. But, uh-oh. Oh, good. Okay.
What? Hi. Okay. I'm not sure why I died. That looked like a really stupid one-tile jump to even think about trying. I'm not even sure what just happened there. Outside of this is a well-programmed game. Ducked under it. Good, these usually lead to checkpoints. Great. That is one thing I don't see here right now. Thank you. guess the exit is a checkpoint of sorts. Oh, now they're actually moving. The crate up there, at least. Police cars are finally actually moving. Making me actually think about how to dodge them. Sneaky, that one. Wow, this one was easy. First try on that one. Yeah, let's see where these boxes are really quick. I'm keeping an eye on Dark Falls in 9. Didn't really want to get that box. I guess it's mine now. I don't know if it matters which place I actually finish in for the purposes of getting the gems. Only those crystals. I saw that last race.
I really hope there aren't any like random crits on the opposite side of the road when I make these like really bad slow turns. That's the one box I'm gonna miss now. Yep, it said 19 out of 20. I did not see the comeback. I hosted it too late and saw that JSR had won. Well, at least that's what I think I saw. Dark Falls has a bow. Flaming Passion. Uh-oh. I just zipped up because I took the... had to run outside for something. What's the targeting thing do? Or is that only relevant in other levels anyway? Now I see the spark spot on the floor. Oh good, really small platforms I have to jump up to. And you can even see his feet kind of clipping through them. Everything else they've done in this game, cutting his pants off is like really tame. Antlers did it, and it's over. Alright, now stop watching that and go back to off. Oh, it moved. I see what's going on now. Author Blues is for some reason doing 380 stars on a weeknight. Yeah, sure. Good job, game. That's the dumbest mechanic of this entire series, by the way, punching apples away. Fortunately, it's not an important one. It's just really dumb. You showed shadow there, game. That's like the biggest lie of 3D gaming. Like, if your shadow is there, you should be able to land on it. Unless it is otherwise clearly in a pit. Okay. Throw lives at finding not secrets here. Really, game? Because I have this, like, really terrible thing. Oh, God. Mechanics are getting worse because now it's triggering the super spin to hit more than one box when I just want to do, no, just a normal spin. I only want to destroy the bottom box.
No, sorry, you super spinned, and now you just destroyed everything, including the TNT box. Just like that. Apparently, super spinning and like bouncing off him and everything else did nothing there. Next trick that this game has decided to pull on a... I was over his head! This game has some very questionable mechanics. We can conclusively say that Crash 2 was, in fact, the good one. Double jump. I have to do a slide jump spin, double jump.
My God.
I've rarely seen speedruns of this. I know, I think Crash 3 actually opened AGDQ 14. Or like, maybe it was 15, but like, it was one of them. What even? I have questions. Like a fruit cannon shot or something now that I'm supposed to be using. First thing we're doing is doing that. Okay, now I see it is making use of the ammo. Okay, so we're not going to get it now because the game has a mechanic that is brand new and it's not very clear how to actually use it. And I went to the menu and I tried to access anything that told me about it. Okay. Okay. I don't see the Nitro Buster anyway, so we're missing all those boxes.
Crash, Coco, remember, it is not only Dr. Cortex that we battle. Beware of Uka Uka, my children. He is a far more dangerous enemy than anyone can imagine.
Hi. Star Fox level, because all I'm doing is barrel rolls. How exciting and innovative this level is. Like, if this is the PlayStation 1's maximum power, give me Star Fox 64 again. It's all the way on the other side of the map. Can we get back to Kitana? It's a health balloon? Done. We had an out. I guess we've had like one outdoor desert level. I don't know why I was supposed to jump. Trust a blind-ish jump over a pit that I previously saw an alligator jumping out of. Where does this go? Work actually? Is this like the intention? I'm just like sneak past them? See, I wanted to get back up and slide again, and instead that happened. I must have hit jump 5 times in there and I got 0 jumps out of it. And holding it there doesn't actually keep me ducking. There's a checkpoint up there. Maybe next time I'll go up there and get that and then come back to this. That didn't work out. Isn't that crawling? Oh, what? Nice of you to tell me that halfway through, game. Let's call it there. I hope I never have to go through that room again. First clear gem I've gotten in a while. I get it. The level's name was Bug Light. Oh, he talked.
This is the part where I'm supposed to be angry, full of rage, incensed beyond belief. Once again, you have outsmarted and outspun my best henchmen. I should be rather upset, shouldn't I?
And in fact, we're furious. But it seems you have overlooked one small detail, you little orange delivery boy. Now that you have gathered all the crystals, all we have to do is taken from you.
Should have like left them at home.
Fast Bandicoot, for the last time, give the crystals to me.
Okay. Why'd the other mask go after him? I don't understand what my mask is doing chasing this. Oh, that's his sled that's doing that, I guess. I'm really glad I didn't just jump in the hole. Is that actually GG, though?
Defeated again. This is not fair. Maybe I should retire to a nice big beach with a nice big drink and a woman with nice big bags of ice for my head.
It's not over, Bandicoot. There are still the Dens. We still have a chance to triumph.
No. Well, I mean, the spoiler was there at the very beginning because you enter the time twister and there's a thing that goes to DLC land and it says stage 31. And so you're left with, okay, I guess there's 30 stages in this game. And I just cleared 25. So unless the boss stages are 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30, I'm missing 5. Yo, what's up, Dragon? No, I really don't. Crash 2 is actually enjoyable. Like, it got to the end and there were a couple of, like, wonky mechanics, but it was nothing, like, terrible. Whereas this stage is kind of... This game is like, no. It's not as bad as Crash 1, but there's enough just, like... These games feel very hastily thrown together, and if these were all three PlayStation 1 games... Then you figure, when did the PlayStation 1 come out? 95, 96? It was that era. It might have been 97. Because the 64, I think, came out in mid-late 96. So, yeah, it came out in 96. So, that means these games came out before the PlayStation 2 was out. So, they came out in that 3 or 4 year gap. So, to put out... These games, and 2 and 3 are effectively the exact same formula. Yeah, I know they're not terrible for their time, but then the remake added wonky physics with, like, these ledge clips. The camera was really annoying in a few spots. I mean, really, my single biggest complaint has been the single tile platforms, and if it was easier to land on them, this game would be a lot, like, better. And then, like, to make... Like, in stage 21, it was, because that was the 21 button. There's, like, a block floating in the middle of free space that you clearly have to, like, probably double jump out to hit. And it's a single tile block to trigger more crates appearing. And it's like, do I really want to, like, hit this box? This feels terrible. I'm not even going to bother with this. Crash 3, I feel like, is the only game I didn't actually game over in, so it does have that going for it. Might not have game over in Crash 2 either. Crash 1 was a game over fest, because it was like you got into a stage with a bad jump and you were just done. So, I mean... I guess now what? This takes care of a blind game on the list, at least. Yeah, I mean, that second driving stage got me all the lives. Which itself was that was the bad stage of this game. Which is surprising, because there were a lot of stages that were weird. Might be right, actually. Spyro Trilogy... So I'm playing Blossom Tales next, but Spyro Trilogy is sitting right next to it, ready to be played. Yeah, I feel like I'm not quite ready to stop streaming anything tonight. Spyro 1 was actually legitimately fun. Actually fun! That's a ringing endorsement. No, it really was. actually fun, Mr. Cab 55. Spyro 1 was good. That was in the month Pie versus Spike month of mushrooms and madness or whatever else. Madness and Mayhem 2018, I want to say. It was like one of the first games I had. I actually went and grabbed the disc at the local retro game shop to play it. Spyro 1, I also like had played enough at a friend's house. And then like playing it here, it was like, wow, we only played around in the first hub and never did anything in this game. And part of that was because I was at a friend's house who, they were bad at video games. There, I said it. Although they did get me through the Star Cup in Mario Kart, the original Mario Kart. It was weird because they couldn't clear the Flower Cup and I couldn't clear the Star Cup. So then we just kind of said, hey, we could do two player and... You know, a trade was made. Not bad at those games, at least. I'm not even going to say they're not bad at racing games, though, because they never figured out Uniracers. Like, that was the game I owned, that I owned both, you know, literally and metaphorically on the block. Uniracers. Their little brother destroyed my Mario Mania strategy guide. I'm not salty about that at all. It's alright. And in retrospect, their little brother was like probably Little Cab's age when it happened, so I shouldn't be mad. But it did lead to me like, whenever they asked me, why didn't you bring over the strategy guide? I'm like, dude, your brother's going to destroy it. I'm not bringing it over. Let me see what else there is to do right now, I guess. I could do learning for 3D World. I could pop in another ancient game and just see what happens. I don't want to stay up too late given tomorrow morning is going to be Blossom Tales. Which makes me feel like this is going to actually become a Zelda randomizer stream from here. I said tomorrow morning is Blossom Tales. And that is some blind Zelda looking game that... Yeah, there's another ringing endorsement of a description. Blind Zelda looking, I don't know. I actually do kind of want to, you know, when an indie game looks cool enough and that limited run picks it up and then you find out it has good reviews on top of that and everything else, it's like, okay. And then it looks like a favorite game. Like, the big thing with Zelda Randomizer and all these games like it, right, is you end up with this inevitable question of what happens when Nintendo decides to shut this down. Because it takes one dumb executive to do it. And then it's all over. So, all somebody needs to do, right, is set up another game. Nintendo does not have the monopoly on hearts and a button to use sword. You just set up another game and you do the exact same thing. Problem is solved. So, the plan right now is to play it solo. I have no idea how long it is. From a blind perspective, and like I know there's websites out there that have these estimates and I just haven't ever looked at them, but yeah, I'm just playing it. I might not even finish it. The blind game schedule right now is Blossom Tales, Spyro, Spyro 2, Spyro 3. Spyro 1 will not be blind, but realistically I've only played it to completion once, and I've only played it past the first world that one time. How long to beat? That's the site. Were the credits the same on all three games? I feel like they were. So I beat 35% of Crash 3. I don't really understand why that's there. So there's stage 31. You know, the more I think about this, there was no such thing as DLC on the PlayStation 1, so that's weird. Yeah, pretty much. Yo, we got a thing. Yo, it's... Oh, we have to put in initials. Look at that. Look at... My name's up there. We got 36, we got a percent for that.